Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on Cloud Firestore. Now, in this episode, we are going to talk about transactions. So without further ado, let's jump right into it. Okay, now in the previous episode, we have talked about batched updates and we have updated both the LA document and the New York document favorites color to be green. Both of them were blue and both of them succeeded, so they were written. Now, what if we want to grab the name, let's see here, for the Los Angeles here. I will just make this disappear so we can see a little bit more here. So what if we want to have this name grabbed to our client and then do something with it and then write it again? Now, that is called a transaction. We first read some data and then we write some data. What you could think about is, let's say, point system where we have, let's say, 100 points on the database and you want to increment it. You just read it and add one to it and then write it. Now, I believe that most of you who already followed along this playlist journey already know that, that is what counters are for, and you are perfectly correct. As of Firebase 6.0.0, we can now have increments, so go ahead and take a look at the previous videos if you don't know what I'm talking about. You can use safely increment, or maybe I believe it's called distributed counters. That's what it's called. If we have a large amount of updates, and I believe the video is called counting likes or counter likes or likes counter, something like that. Okay, so now we want to grab our name here and add something to this string, say a plus. And we want to write it back in here. Okay, why do we want to do this? Well, basically, when we grab this name, maybe some other party wants to grab this name. Well, it can't, because we are working in a transaction and we have to finish the write. So we have to first read and then write. Till then, everything is locked here. Nobody can interfere. So, let's do that now in the code. So let's go to Xcode, and as you can see, I have already added our run transaction button and added our reference to our LA document. Okay, now if this sounds or looks like a little bit weird for you, go ahead and take a look at the whole playlist, the whole master course on Cloud Firestore, and you will understand everything, what this Firestore reference manager is, or what this city's key is, or yeah. So what we want to do first is create a database. So let Firestore database, so db equals Firestore dot Firestore, and that is because we want to run a transaction, and transactions run on Firestore dot Firestore. So db dot run transaction, and it's the only one, so let's use that. We have an update block and a completion, so let's hit return there, and as you can see, we have a transaction and an error pointer. So transaction and error pointer. Okay, and let's go into the completion, and we are going to get back an object, and that can be anything, an integer, a string, and so on. So let's name this object an error here, and let's see here. I will just copy all of this error handling code and paste it in there. So if there is any error, we just print out the localized description, and otherwise we just print out successfully ran transaction, and with object. Maybe we have an object, maybe it is nil, but if we do return an object here, we want to have this printed out. So let's copy that out and paste that in there. Okay. And maybe what's wrong here? So yeah, we need to have string interpolation. And yeah, for example, let's return nil for now. And I believe we should get rid of all of those. Yes. Let's hit Command B and let's see if everything is okay. Great. Now, let's turn our focus here under this run transaction. And we don't want to return nil. We want to create that transaction. So what we are going to do here is, first of all, read from the database and then write to it. So let's tackle the first part. We are going to read from the database. And when we read from the Firestore database, we get back a document snapshot. So let's create a document snapshot here. And I will name this transaction document. Okay, and it will be of type document snapshot. And because when we read from the database, we could get back an error. So we are going to try to get this document, tr document, and we will add that into a do try catch statement. So let's just type that out, do try catch. Okay, and let's have here an error. So if we do have that error, we are just going to print out the error's localized description, and we are going to return nil, because as you can see, it expects us to return something. So this object will be a nil. And finally, we are going to try to create this document snapshot. So I'm just copy and pasting it there. And that equals to transaction. There we go, transaction. And get data, get document, sorry, get document. And as you can see, this document snapshot froze. And that is why we needed to add this into a do try catch statement. So let's have that, and it requires a document reference, and that reference is right here. We want to grab our document from the LA named document. Okay, and let's just paste that in there. Okay, if all of this succeeds, we should be ready with a TR document. Okay. Now, we want to grab the name of the document, and let me just see, show you the structure of our code here. We have LA, and we have a field here, name, and Los Angeles New is the value currently. And let's go back and let's get that field, rather the value of that field. So, because this is an optional, we want to guard let unwrap that. And I will call this old name because we will change it. And that is tr document dot data. And this is optional because we want to unwrap the name field. And this will be as string else. And we want to return. Now we want to return nil because we want to return something. And here will be an error. And we want to construct an error, an NS error. This error pointer is an NS error. So I just copy and paste this from the documentation. It's quite cumbersome to create it on our own. And it's in there. So I would just copy this out and paste it in there. So we are creating an NS error with a domain and a code and user info. Yeah, that is really it. So tr document here. And finally, we want to add this to our error pointer. And let me just take a peek. Yes, error pointer dot pointy will be our error, our created error. So let's see here, error pointer dot pointy equals this error that we have just created, and that makes sure that in this completion we do get back this error. And I believe let's fix this. Yeah, we need to add a bang there. Okay, so now that we have our old name, we want to, let's see what's wrong here. Oh, maybe we want to have this as an optional. Okay, now we have our old name, so let's create our new name, and that is pretty simple. Let new name equals old name, and we will add in here some kind of string like plus, and this is just for the example's sake. So now that we have read some data from the database and we have changed the old name to the new name, it's time to add this new name, or rather update this new name to the LA document. And that is pretty simple. We grab our transaction, and as you can see, we can get, set, delete, update. We are going to update our data, and the data basically is name and new name. Okay, there it is. And for the document, that is the document reference, and it's here where we have added to the LA document. Okay, and let's add that in there. So basically that is it, and we return nil. Now if we would want to, we can return nil, it doesn't really matter, then we get the object as nil, but we want to basically use this new name, then we can simply return not nil but this new name. Okay, and then we will have this object printed out here. So either way, it doesn't really matter. If you want to use this new data, then you can add it to this completion handler. Okay, so yeah, let's do that. So let's build and run, and let's take a look at our database. And as you can see, under LA we have this name Los Angeles New. So let's run our transaction, and it says Los Angeles New Plus. Let's do that again. So it's grabbing from the database, it's reading, and currently it is Los Angeles New Plus Plus. And let's tap again, it's reading that, and it's appending this new string, space plus. Okay, and yeah, that is basically it. Now you know how you can run transactions on Cloud Firestore. Now wasn't that easy? I hope you did enjoy this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified of new videos, because we are going to continue with Cloud Firestore, and we are going to take a look at delete, queries, database security, and much, much more. So this is the complete Cloud Firestore course for you in Swift 5, of course, and for iOS. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.